I had a chat with Diane. She said she was at the bar drinking with Nick at the time of the murder. We need to confirm her story. Let's talk to Nick at the diner.
Very well, Agent Morgan. I have to head back to the department and clear up some paperwork. Go with Emily to the A&G diner.
Okay, then.
I'll show you the way. The diner's open from 9 to 2100.
Just as we suspected, Zach. Diane is the key to this case. I have a feeling she will lead us right to the criminal.
That's Kaysen. Looks like the show has just begun, and it has an all-star cast. Emily, do you know a man named Forrest Kaysen?
Kaysen? Yes, I know him. The sapling salesman, right? He always uses strange comparisons when he talks.
I'd like to know more about him. What does he do when he comes to town?
He's a salesman, so I guess he sells things. Maybe he comes on vacation. We haven't seen many tourists recently, but he comes pretty often.
Is that all?
Well, now that you mention it, he seems quite friendly with the Ingrams, with Isaac and Isaiah. Maybe you should ask them about Kaysen.
Okay, I will. Emily, don't you find it a bit suffocating to be around George so much?
Well, we aren't always together. And anyway, I've gotten used to him.
Impressive. Women are very adaptable.
No, it's not like that, actually. I mean, George is hard-headed, sure, but he's also a hard-working man. That's why the townsfolk trust him so much.
The very epitome of the rural sheriff.
That's right. He isn't some hotshot FBI agent. This place isn't like the city. Everyone knows everyone else.
What about you and Anna? Were you too close?
No, not close, really. I don't seem to have much in common with teenagers nowadays. All they talk about are boys, clothes, and accessories. I don't have much interest in any of those things.
There is a gap between a teenager and being in your 20s.
Everyone's different, that's all. Me and you, too.
Zach, I'm not liking the way this conversation is heading. Let's concentrate on driving instead.
Uh-huh.
Jack, here's the Ben Franklin you wanted.
Give it to me. Hey there, Benjamin. I wanted to talk to you. Have you heard this yet? I'll tell you another one when I see you again.
Zach, did you see that? It was as if we weren't here.
I wonder what that was all about. Did it make sense to you?
Let's just focus on getting to the diner and cut the chit-chat.
The A&G Diner. Wonder what the A&G stand for. Any ideas, Emily?
Nope, I don't know either.
Air and gravity, perhaps? Access and games? Aliens and Godzilla? Who knows?
Is it important to know? Why don't you just ask Nick?
Oh, I will. But first, I need to eat. Wonder what's good here.
Welcome, Mr. Agent.
Hi, Olivia. Let me have your special for today. And some fresh coffee.
Our special today is turkey. A turkey and gravy sandwich. Sound good?
Oh, perfect. Emily, you eat something, too. It'll be on the FBI.
Okay, then. I'll go all out. I'll have the T-bone steak. I usually can't order it because it's a little too expensive.
Mrs. Olivia Cormack, I am here for Mr. Stewart's lunch. If it is ready, I'd thank you a bunch.
Yes, of course. Just a moment. Here you go. The usual. One turkey, strawberry jam, and cereal sandwich.
Sounds like the sinner's sandwich. Self-inflicted punishment to atone for past sins. He's setting an example.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, you should try this wonderful lunch. It's more than a delicious, tasty crunch. So says Mr. Stewart.
No, that's fine. I've just ordered my own lunch.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, Mr. Stewart's order is delicious, I should mention. And Mr. Nick Cormack is a genius for creating this perfection. So says Mr. Stewart.
Still, I have a hunch I might not like it. You sure that sandwich is that good?
Mr. Francis York Morgan, making decisions based on intuitions is always a sign of bad FBI agents. So says Mr. Stewart.
Harry, you're right. I'll give it a try. I can't believe it. This is fantastic. It's really good. Olivia, I'm sorry, but can I change my order? I'll have what Harry is having. Nick and Diane. They hardly make the perfect couple, do they? Is it widely known that they go drinking together, just the two of them?
To be honest, I don't pay attention to these things.
Not into local gossip?
Well, when I moved here, I was still in high school, and I kept wearing the same wild clothes from my school in Seattle. I was young back then. And before I knew it, there were rumors all over the school. She'll screw anyone. That's what they said. Totally unfounded, of course. Anyway, after that, I just sort of chose not to really trust gossip.
I get where you're coming from. I used to dress like a hardcore punk rocker when I was in high school.
You? A punk rocker?
Nobody took my side. Even when I had good grades, people rejected me just because of what I wore. I was young back then, too.
Even still, I just don't see you as a punk rocker.
And you laugh? Look at you. No makeup on. Dressed in uniform, eating a steak for lunch. Okay, back to work. Let's talk to Nick. There's something I'd like to confirm with you, Olivia, if that's okay.
Yes. Well, so long as it doesn't take too long.
First, what were you and Nick doing on the night of the murder?
I was here in the diner. Nick said he was going to the bar for a couple of drinks.
Does he go to the bar often? Leaving you to hold up the fort?
Yes. He says he enjoys the conversation with Diane. I thought they went drinking again together that night.
Do the three of you ever go drinking together?
Well, you see, I'm really not into art.
And your husband is well-versed in the arts then, I take it?
Oh, yes. Looking at art and talking about it is his way of relaxing.
People just aren't what they seem. Like a certain someone who was into punk rock 10 years ago.
You are absolutely right, Emily. But you can be an art lover and a liar at the same time. One more thing, Olivia. You just said that you aren't interested in art.
That's right. And...
So, how come I bumped into you at the art gallery? Didn't seem like Nick brought you there. You were there alone.
I like trees, is the thing. That's why I went there.
Surely you'd be better off in the forest rather than an art gallery, then. I think you went to the gallery not to see trees, but to see Diane, right? You don't want to answer? Or perhaps this isn't the right place to ask.
Meet me in the backyard. You can get there from the parking lot. I'll wait for you there for an hour after we close up.
They close at 2100. Should we get something to drink and wait? Agent York, what do we do now?
I want to hear what Olivia has to say. Let's kill time until the diner closes.
Okay, then I'm going to make a trip back to the department. I'll see you in the backyard later.
Okay, sounds good.
See you later, then.
Zach, about Olivia. I presume she wants to tell us something about Nick and Diane. Let's hope it's not just something for the gossip columns.
You! Zack, don't you think there are a lot of good-looking women in this town?
It's like heaven compared to the town we grew up in.
Do you remember Liz?
The prom queen? Elizabeth Scott Moore. She could be royalty with a name like that. But you know, she was like an actress from a B-movie, wasn't she?
Now then, young fella, how do you feel about your current vehicle?
My vehicle? It's a piece of crap, but I'm not here to talk about that.
Then how about a little treasure hunt? Listen up, young man. My junkyard is actually a mountain of treasure. All kinds of treasure lies in those mountains of junk. The problem is, there's so many, I've lost track of where everything is. You've caught on already. I can see it in your eyes. I need you to head out in the yard and find certain things for me. If you help me out, I'll customize your car a little.
What are you talking about?
Didn't I tell you to shut up and listen to your superiors? Now, will you do it or not?
I don't see any reason to refuse.
Well said. First, I'll need some low gear parts. With that, I'll be able to boost the engine of your car. You'll find one around E5. Go! Don't just stand there, get going! This is it. This will save your life someday, son.
You sure know how to exaggerate.
You imbecile. Engine boost is vital for bringing back soldiers alive from war.
Engine boost?
Of course. Engine boost is the basis of everything.
Let me tell you a war story, son. I was leading my unit at the very front line.
Things were bad, and sanitary conditions were worse. Endless guerrilla attacks were stripping us of our manpower. Everyone was tired to their limits.
There was one sergeant who really rubbed me the wrong way. The boys like to call him Crybaby Timothy. He really gave me headaches, I can tell you.
How?
Just by breathing. His posture was bad. He was weak, slow, easily distracted. I have no idea who thought he was capable of combat in a war zone.
He endangered the lives of every member of the unit.
Stomach pains.
The worst stomach ache ever. Every one of us. It was just cooking. He was using food that was contaminated. I flew into the dugout toilet like an Apache chopper returning to base.
I have to tell you, it was a close call. My engine was boosting. And that's what got me there safely, right in the nick of time.
What happened to the unit?
You really want to know? It was a terrible sight. Powerful, athletic men reduced to walking dead. Blinking like crazy, shaking with pain. Their confidence and self-esteem were all crushed. They almost didn't recover.
An interesting story.
So you see the need for engine boost now, do you? I'll keep my side of the promise and get to work on your vehicle.
That badge on him is for a sergeant. Looks like it was sewn on something else before it was sewn onto his shirt. I wonder what that's all about.
I put in longer pistons and optimized your lower gears. That should add boost to your speed when you accelerate. But there's still plenty of stuff I can do to make your car go faster. Just come see me again and I'll customize your car a little more.
To recap, the movie was the fourth sequel in a series that started in 1978.
That's right, Zack. It was Superman IV, The Quest for Peace.
Lex Luthor was back.
Zack, we'll finish our chat later. Let's take a walk around here. Zack, picking up from where we left off.
To recap, the movie was the fourth sequel in a series that started in 1978.
That's right, Zack. It was Superman 4, The Quest for Peace.
Lex Luthor was back. It was played by Gene Hackman. That alone made it a must for all us fans. I don't remember much more about it, though. I'm sure there was more trivia about it. Still, forget 4. Richard Donner directing 1 and 2. Now those two were great movies. Christopher Reeve really shined as Superman.
Actually, Zack, I've got a confession to make.
Promise not to tell anyone because I'd be really embarrassed. I actually liked the first two Superman movies more than the first two Star Wars movies. I think John Williams did a better job with the theme song for Superman. But whenever I try to hum it, it always turns into the Star Wars song somewhere along the way.
I know it's strange, Zack. I know. So, Zack, which Richard Donner film do you like the best?
No need to hurry. Take some time and think it over. Well then, Olivia, talk to me.
Yes. In the beginning, Nick only went to the gallery during the day, but he went so often at some point he became friendly with Diane. They started going out drinking together, and now he doesn't come home until early morning. He always says that they were only drinking when I ask. He blames me for not being able to talk about Turner and Rembrandt, which of course I can't, can I? So what can I say? Finally, I couldn't take it anymore, so I followed him. He did go to the bar, to start with. Diane was there too, but the real problem is where they go to next, right? So I waited outside the bar to see where they might go, and they eventually left the bar and headed for the art gallery. But it was already early morning. but it was still dark. Just before going inside, Diane turned around. It should have been too dark to see me, but I swear, her eyes looked right at me. They seemed to flash for a moment. I was so rattled that I left and went home. The next day, Anna was found dead. I didn't know what to do. I went to the gallery to talk with Diane about it, to confront her. Once I was there, I couldn't find the courage to go through with it. Then I saw you there, and I just felt I had to go home. Nick has been seeing Diane every night recently. He just left for tonight, too. I really don't know what to do.
York, we need to take Nick in for questioning.
No, not yet. This alone isn't enough.
Emily, answer me!
This is Emily. Agent York is with me, too.
I've just received word from Thomas at the Sheriff's Department. Something has happened at Becky's house. He was called in by Quint, but he wasn't making any sense. We have no further details. I've sent Thomas over there. Can you go back him up?
Yes, sir.
One other thing. It sounded like he said, raincoat killer. This may well be related to the murder case. Take all due precautions.
No! It couldn't be! Nick? Oh, please, no! What can I do? Nick!
Oh, Olivia, Nick. Calm down.
Emily, take care of Olivia. I'm heading over to Becky's.
She lives in the big house over by the lake. Hurry!
I just hope this isn't anything serious. Damn it, Zach. We may have screwed up during the investigation. Zach, I have a bad feeling about this. Becky's house is by the lake.